Hello everybody, my name is Aceface, welcome back to EVE Online. In this video, I'm going to be running some Tier 4 Abyss, and I also wanted to discuss a topic that is often being discussed right now, or at least in the middle to end of July, and that is the new skillpoint packages. So first thing, I just want to explain quickly that I'm running these Tier 4 Abysses in the Gila, and I'm doing it because I want to hit this 1 billion mark in my wallet right now. I'm soon there, only 200 million more to go, so only a few more sites. Alright, let's just grab some filaments. Just place the raging electrical one here. But for you guys who don't know, and it's pretty obvious if you have been playing EVE, because it's always been in the launcher, is that they released these new skill point packages. You see these training boost bundles here? And what these do is that these give you Plex, I believe it was Plex, they give you accelerators, so this booster that increases your training speed, and also a bunch of skill points for, I think it was like $40 or something. So based on the price of Plex and the price of skill points, it seems like it's a pretty good deal. I personally speaking do not think it's such a big issue, and I'll get into that, why I think that's the case in a bit. So let's just undock first, because you want to get out of the station, obviously, if you want to run the Abyss. Alright, so the new skill point packages, they seem to be a very controversial issue. And it has a lot to do with the, interfering with the sandbox of EVE Online. Like, EVE Online is supposed to be, a very open world that's always... we have to go to the safe. So there's, always created by the players. Like, everything is created by the players. And when you're using real money to buy... skill points like this, then people don't like it, because these skill points are coming from nowhere, and you know, they're not coming from an actual place, so it's kind of like breaking the immersion or feeling of the sandbox. But I personally don't have a big issue with this, because I don't see how this would really affect players that much. Okay, people are buying now skill points, but I don't think it really matters where they come from. People still have to pay real money, and the main reason I think actually it's not that bad is because you could still buy skill points for real money. It's just that you before had to buy it through Plex and then use the Plex to buy skill extractors. So that is kind of the same way, but. I can still see people, you know, they don't want to. It kind of is discrediting people a bit, you know, who've spent a lot of time grinding skill points through normal training, and then suddenly people come in here and they can just pay a bit of cash and then they have all their skills. So I understand. I'm just saying my opinion here. It's feel free to disagree with me. You can explain your opinion in the comment section below. But I don't have a big issue with this skill point training pack, and I like how. It's getting a bit easier to acquire skills, because I don't like it how it takes forever, absolutely forever. I like having these occasional boosts of skill training, but then, you know, if skills or points are too easy, though, it'll remove the value of skill points away from them. So that is obviously not so a good thing, because you know, then I'll do nothing special, and we want to keep moving here because we do not want to be moving when we've got deep watches on the case. Alright, get these guys here. Yeah, because they've got target painters, and they've got probably a multi-body tracking pylon near them, and they've got rail guns, I believe. So we do not want to just be still with our MWD on. It's going to be big issues. But we are now up to speed, so it seems alright. But these guys can easily kill me if I stop my speed. Especially easy to kill me if I am up close near this transfer conduit, because they've got these I think it's torpedoes or some kind of special missile that goes really slow. But if I'm sitting at zero, then they will be able to hit me, and those do crazy damage. They almost insta kill my shield. Yeah, and this is all this issue with skill points. There was also a big issue when skill you know, the skill extractors and skill injectors came out. And I like the idea of that skill injectors, because of how it allows new players to get skills quicker, because of how the diminishing returns are with the skill injectors. But the thing is, most of the people... Oh, we have updating a game right now. That's why this thing came up. But I like how they got the diminishing returns with skill injector, so it encourages kind of like new players to get on their feet quicker. But the bad thing is that skill injectors still cost quite a bit, so like new players are still not going to use them. So in actuality, it mainly helps people who want to make a bunch of alts, or that's what at least it seems like. People who want to, like, you know, quickly inject maybe like a carrier alt or something like that. So it's not really helping new players that much. Let's see, now let's go to this spy adaptification. See that? They can do some random wrecking shots as well, so you don't want to mess with these deep watches, they can do a lot of damage. Let's keep, let's go to the bioadaptive, let's see if we get anything good from this. 3 mil, nah, it's not so good. So when it's deep watcher waves, you always want to orbit on the transfer conduit, because the transfer conduit is just like, you know, obviously you want to be close to that so you can instantly warp. And also it's just their missiles they'll shoot. You'll see here, they've got these kind of missiles. Yeah, you see these missiles over here? You can see they're going really slowly, these missiles here. Do you see them? These ones here? But if we like go turn our MWD off, or if we just sit at zero even and like idle, those things will annihilate my shields even with just one of them. So imagine if they're two or even three, like in the T5s, like, oh, those guys can be, that will kill you very quickly. Let's go through the transfer conduit, come on please. I have this keybind to drones to take my drones back in with shift F, and in, I think it was something else in the beginning, but it's really convenient. Shift F to shoot with the drone and shift F to remove them. Now I don't want to be locking up this Vela Swarmer. I have actually been buying a few skill injectors. Like, speaking about skill injectors, I have actually been buying a few skill injectors recently, because I've got my clone remapped to be mostly towards the skills of skills like that involve perception and willpower. So it's good for training skills that involve like for example Amar Battleship or Min Matar Battleship. I just finished Min Matar Battleship 5 actually 10 hours ago. But it's these kind of like combat related skills, but often skills that are non-combat related, I train them really slowly. So what I've been doing is I've been buying some skill injectors and using the skill points to train those, because the attributes don't affect, you know, how, what the skill injectors do. It'll be less efficient for me to use the skill injectors if I'm using them on the current on my current combat skills, because then it will it'll not be as efficient, because I may as well just train them normally, because it's just better that way, so I don't have to spend time remapping. Like, I was doing a few of these mining skills, because I want to eventually get good at mining. I've always been doing combat stuff, but it'll be nice to do mining for a change, actually. It's a very relaxing, most relaxing activity, at least so far, it seems like, in EVE Online, actually. The accelerator that skill pack also gives you is quite cool. It's like very boosted, and it gives you crazy amount of attributes. So not only do you get skill packs, but you also get these accelerators, and I think they're really expensive actually. If we go in here, is there any, there's like a special icon I think on it, I can't find them. Kill this Vela. I wonder if we're gonna get any good loot from this site, because it seems like right and so far it's been pretty crap. Yeah, that was okay. I mean, 4 mil. I would like it to be 10 mil from them. Those are like really nice waves. 10 mil from one extraction case? Really delicious. Okay, let's go closer. We've got blue cloud, but no issues with blue cloud right now, because these harrowing Vela Vedmax do hardly any damage to us. Let's get close to this. We've got an automatic suppressor shooting our drones. You can see that the shields have been decreased on them. Shoot our rapid light missiles there. Ooh. Okay, we've got a bit of stuff there. 10 mil. Let's see now. It's really annoying when this happens, where you try to do it and then it just like doesn't work. It's really annoying. It happens so often because we're going so fast, so the game doesn't have enough time to update when I just when I click loot tool, then it's already too far away. Keep it range at the gate to always be in range. That is in the not a case. There's not deep watches. Though I used to, when I was like an alpha clone, I always would buy these daily alpha injectors to get my skill points to max skill points. And that was interesting because the daily alpha injectors are quite a bit cheaper than plex per day. And especially now, actually, I've realized that daily alpha injectors have gone down quite a bit in price. I think that's something to do that the plex prices have also gone down quite a bit, because back then I think plex cost like over 3 million. Now they cost like 2 million or something. I've also considered once like setting up skill point farms, but it just seems like so much headache work. You know, once I when the alpha clones came out initially, I made like 50 alts, 50 alpha alts, because I thought you could extract skills from alpha clones. Then I realized, oh wait, you can't extract skills from alpha clones. Then I got checkmated right there. It was like a waste of time. So I had like 50 or so random alts with like actually when I was joining my current corp, Brave Empire, they were like, oh, we need all your alts. I was like, really, all my alts? So I had to like look through all of those guys and list every single one. It was a real headache, but luckily I didn't miss any, and I was accepted. Oh, maybe the guys at Brave were just like, nah, he's got too many, I can't bother to look through them. Yeah, but it was a big epic fail. I remember like staying up really late and just being so hyped, like, oh yeah, I'm gonna earn so much isk, man, gonna be earning so much with all these skill injectors, right? Turns out that's not the case. You just wasted a bunch of time, isk. I'm just assigning my drones on these random sleep crews. Honestly, they can't really do anything. It doesn't seem like they're any kind of stasis webifiers or MWD ones. Those are the only ones I'm really interested in. Their newts are hardly do any damage. In fact, I probably should go for the confusers, because then I'll be able to destroy them quicker, since they'll be making my missiles do a bit less damage. But my missiles are still not even my main damage type, so in actuality it probably won't even make much of a difference. Have my heavy missile reload, because that's what I always use to take out these extraction cages. You know, an interesting thing is, what, you can keep it ranged now. Oh, I thought you couldn't keep it range at extraction cases. Or maybe it's the wreck. I see now. Yeah, you can't keep a range of wrecks for some reason. Though you should be able to keep it range, right? I don't see any reason why you shouldn't be able to keep it range from wrecks. Seems like there was an empty one there, I think. Put the drones on each FELT's lancer, just like this. Go in here. Okay, so soon done with this site in the Abyssal Dead Space run. Only a few more of these FELTs left. But yeah, please let me know what you guys think about the new skill point pack in the comments. Like, it's interesting that I never really would have thought that these kind of things cause so much controversy, but I've been reading on the EVE Online Reddit especially a lot. I see that a lot of people are really raging hard over these things, and I never really get why all the fuss about. I mean, I understand why, but to me it doesn't really seem like that much big of a deal. Sometimes I feel like people just want to be angry about something. Like, there's always a new topic people want to be angry about, and not just in EVE Online, but in general in life, there's always some kind of new issue going on. All right, Scylla. Yeah, so let me know what you guys think. It's interesting to know what other people think. Okay, only two more cruisers left. Let's take this guy out. So doesn't seem like we've got that great stuff from this one, like 40 mil. I mean, I guess, and then probably we're gonna get like 30 something when we actually sell it. So it doesn't seem like that great loot we got right there. But we finished this Abyssal Dead Space site. Dead Space site. This is a bit of a tongue twister, Abyssal Dead Space. In 12 minutes, about. So, I mean, that's alright time. You know, I don't realize much of a difference in the time difference with T5s and T4s and T5s. There's a slight difference, but it could also be because my ship uses blinged out damage mods in the T5, so it'll obviously do more damage, complete the sites quicker, but it's not that big of a difference in the DPS, only slightly. The main reason I actually have this blinged out ones is because of the fitting requirements. It allows me to fit a lot better stuff when I, because the faction drone damage amplifiers do much more damage than the, have a lot more less CPU than the Tech 2 ones, the cheaper Tech 2 ones that I'm using right now. Okay, let's see if we get any alright loot. Like, we had like 40 mil, so let's see if we get actually 40 mil or we're just gonna get completely ripped off. You know, often it happens I get completely ripped off in the abyss. It's not nice. So 39. Let's see how much we get from this. Put these in here. Oh, actually, we don't want to put that blueprint. These blueprints, we always want to put them in junk, you know. I don't want those in just clogging up my inventory here. Stack all to make it a bit easier. And then, blop, 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 sell. Let's see. Now, how much do we get from this? 30 mil, okay, that was pretty hard rip-off right there, so we should have got 39, but then just come here with, oh, you got 30 mil, oh, nice. Not nice at all, nah. But we're at 800 mil now, so we're only 180 mil left until 1 billion. Thanks for watching, guys, hope you enjoyed, and that was me talking about the new skill injector packs, or skill point packs. Let me know what you think about them in the comment section below. I mean, there's nothing wrong with disagreeing. Just be respectful, and if you come across people who disagree with you, just be respectful in the comments. That's all I ask. I'll catch you guys later.